Hello everyone, my name is Milla Laita, and I'm working here as a project manager. And this project that I'm going to tell you about is mainly about the map production renewal, but I will tell you more about stock information this time. Why we started this project? It happened in about 2015, and the situation was like this at that time. We had so many different kind of map services, and base maps were different in every place, and printed material was different than the electronical, and it depended who made the map, which map she was or he was using, and so on. So we saw that something has to be done. And this is what we are trying to achieve next year, 2018. We hope we have uniform map style with same colors and symbols everywhere, so that the customers can see that this is the HSL map, not just any other map, and they can trust the information on the map. The base map is OpenStreetMap everywhere, and it's very easy to update and quick to do the updates. We can do it like every day if we need to make some changes. It's easy and quick to do. And one more thing was reducing the manual work, which we really wanted to do. There was a lot of time and money spent on this map production earlier, and now we hope we have a very automatic system to provide maps, and it's also updates and precise information for customers. When we started 2015, we were wondering what's the first thing to do, and we wanted to make new bus stop posters, or also for trams and frontline stops. There is about 3,000 stops in HSL area with the shelter, which means that there is a poster at the stop. So it's not possible to make it manually, so we needed an automatic system to make these posters. And here you see two different kind of posters. These are in production since July this year. And as you see, they are a little bit different elements on both posters. And now I will show you how these posters are generated. And before we started, we asked the customers what's the most important thing you need to be on the stop. And the customers say that it's the line of the lists. Even though you know where you're going and which line you need to take, the first thing at the stop was that they always check, this is the right stop, does the bus number 52 goes really here. So we wanted to put these things like quite big on the top of the poster, so everyone can see it easily, and it's the first thing you really see at the stop. And as you see, these are a little bit different shape, and it depends what else information there is at the stop, because there is also some stops where it's like more than 50 lines going through that stop. It gives a very different information at that stop compared to the stop where it's like 2 or 3 lines only. So when we start to generate the poster, it's automatically the generator tries to fit all the information on the poster, and it changes the shape of the elements as it goes further and further with these elements. And the second thing the customers wanted to be on the stop was the timetable. And at first the generator tries to fit the all the timetable in the poster like this, but if it's too long and it doesn't fit, then it changes to the other place of the poster on the top, and at the same time the list of the line changes the shape. And the next thing the generator will fit on the poster is the map. It's not a very huge area we want it to be on the map, but we want it to be something that serves the customers getting off the bus at the stop and maybe want to change to another stop, to another bus, so you can see all the stops nearby where you get off. And this is a bit old version. We have now more of the street names on the map, so you can also use this for walking some closed areas. And this labeling of the stops, as you see, the picture is not very sharp, but in some labels there's just a list of the lines. And it depends on how many bus runs through that stop. If there's a lot of lines, there is just a list of the lines. But then if it's less than 5 or less, there is also the destination of the line. And this is something that we are really proud of, because our developers has used a lot of time to place all these labels. And they're not overlapping each other, and they're not overlapping the stops, or they're not behind the index map. And this is something that we can use in many, many map products. And it's not an easy thing to do. If you have been ever working with maps, you know what I'm talking about. And then, if there is still room on the poster, we will show this roots of the lines, kind of a spider map, showing all the lines and the stops where they are running. And there has also been some problems to fit all the stops on the map. So some of them are shown all the way. This is the last stop and the destination. But some of the stop lines have to be cutted and just show the stops that fit in and the destination of the line. Okay. This is all made with open data and open source code, just like our journey planner. And if someone is interested in to use the same kind of idea to generate some stop posters or maybe something else, I don't know, you may have good ideas where you can use this kind of information, it's free to use for everyone. The next thing we are going to do is the poster for stations, terminals, hospitals, shopping malls, these kind of places. It's quite same than the bus poster, but maybe this spider map will need some fix, because it's not on the stop and our developers need to figure out how to present these kind of situations. And just a short teaser, what else have you been doing? If someone's interested, I can show you the user interfaces for guide for drivers. We don't produce paper guides anymore, only this kind of guide. And we also have a map generator, which we use for every need we have for maps. And then also this user interface for poster publisher. I was thinking to show it to you, but actually it's not working at the moment, so I won't show it now, but if someone is interested, I can tell you how it works. Okay, thank you.